While she's doing that, let's think about our groups. The groups are all of three. Is it still multiplication if we have a group of three and a group of four and a group of five? Could we use multiplication for a group of three and a group of four and a group of five? Add them all up. Could we do multiplication? What do you think?
It would be 15.
Well, you could, so you added those. How did 3 plus 4?
Because there's three groups of, there's five groups of three, and then you 3 plus 3 equals 6, and then you're, with another 6, 12, and one more 6, it would equal 15.
Okay. So we just had an explanation of five groups of three. Oh, it's okay. We'll come see in just a minute. We just had an explanation of five groups of three that we're going to look at in just a minute. Can you show us? We were looking for three groups of three in our picture. What'd you come up with? Can you show us? What'd you do? Tell us what you did. One more box? Okay. Thank you. What do you guys think about if we add one more box? What do you think, Derek?
Then it will be 3 times 3.
Okay. So that was my funny little design there. So I can put another 3 in there. If it's the same size box, we can maybe guess that it's 3 still. Okay. So then we said all together that would be 9. So something that I'm noticing from your idea is you said 5 times 3. You said that would be 5 groups of 3. They're always, the groups are always the same size. 3, 3, 3, we didn't have 3 different numbers in here. They were always the same size. They were equal groups. So this would be 5 equal groups of 3. Wow, that was a lot on multiplication.